Lord God, you know us too well. We would rather hide and mutter and weep than proclaim the power of your love. The world is a difficult place. We fear so much. We don't want to offend anyone. But your love and presence are not offensive. They are empowering and healing. Love is offered to you, even when you fear or are unsure of your faith. Know that God is with you. Be not afraid. Alleluia. Our gathering song is printed on the screen. It's from the Lutheran Book of Worship, number 527, All Creatures of Our God and God.
Thank you.
Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let's pray. God of wind and fire, embolden us this day to receive your power. Help us to proclaim the wondrous things that you have done and continue to do in our lives. Give us strength and courage to share the good news of your love and your presence. For we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. I invite you to be seated for the readings.
Reading this morning comes from Genesis chapter 11. The builders of the Tower of Babel tried to make a name for themselves by building their tower to the heavens. God scatters them, confusing their language so that they cannot understand one another. The miracle at Pentecost reverses this story, drawing many different peoples together into the new people of God. The reading from Genesis. Now the whole earth had one language and the same words. And as they migrated from the east, they came upon a plain in the land of Shinar and settled there. And they said to one another, "Come, let us make bricks and burn them thoroughly." And they had brick for stone and bitumen for mortar. Then they said, "Come, let us build ourselves a city and a tower with its top in the heavens. And let us make a name for ourselves. Otherwise, we shall be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth." The Lord came down to see the city and the tower which mortals had built. And the Lord said, "Look, they are one people, and they have all one language. And this is only the beginning of what they will do. Nothing that they propose to do will now be impossible for them. Come, let us go down and confuse their language there, so that they will not understand one another's speech." So the Lord scattered them abroad from there over the face of all the earth, and they left off building the city. Therefore it was called Babel, because there the Lord confused the language of all the earth. And from there the Lord scattered them abroad over the face of all the earth. The word of the Lord. And our psalm this morning is 104, 24 to 34. How manifold are your works, O Lord! In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures.
Yonder is the sea, great and wide, with its waters too many to number, living things both small and great.
There go the ships to and fro, and Leviathan, which you made for the sport of it.
All of them belong to you, to give them their food in due season.
You give it to them, they gather it. You open your hand, and they are filled with good things.
When you mark their faces, they are terrified. You take away their breath, they die, and return to their dust.
You send forth your spirit, and they are created. And so you renew the face of the earth.
May the glory of the Lord endure forever. The Lord rejoices in all your works.
You look at the earth and it trembles. You touch the mountains and they smoke.
I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will praise my God while I have my being.
May these words of mine please God. I will rejoice in the Lord. Our second reading this morning comes from Acts chapter 2. Before Jesus ascended into heaven, he told his disciples they would be filled with the Holy Spirit. Now, surrounded by the signs of fire, wind, and a variety of languages in their midst, the people were amazed and astonished at Jesus' promise coming true. The reading from Acts. When the day of Pentecost had come, the apostles were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs, in our own languages we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power. All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, 'What does this mean?' But others sneered and said, 'They are filled with new wine.' But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, 'Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they will prophesy. And I will show portents in the heaven above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." The word of the Lord.
The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the 14th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Philip said to Jesus, "Lord, show us the Father and we will be satisfied." And Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own, but the Father who dwells in me does his work. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe in me because of the works themselves. Very truly I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and in fact, will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If in my name you ask me for anything, I will do it. If you love me, you will keep my commandments, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it neither sees him or knows him. You know him, because he abides with you, and he will be in you." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated.
Mm-hmm.
So your microphone systems are so potent here, I thought I'd try and use it, even though I want to come down here and preach from down here today. So I'm going to try and hold on to this and preach, but I preach with my hands and moving, and so we'll try it, okay? You guys are trying new things today, so I can try new things too. It is good to be here today. I'm Pastor Bonnie Schelter Brown. I think most of you know me. My husband is Pastor Rick, of course, and he sends greetings especially to you confirmants today. I know some of you asked if he could be here today, and it just didn't feel right for him. He was not feeling too great yesterday or today, but he sends his love to you and to the whole congregation. And so so I just say that to you, that greetings from Pastor Rick as well today, okay? So, we had big readings today. Did you remember them all? Should I quiz you on our readings? Maybe I should quiz the people behind you, eh, instead of you? Yeah, no. The first reading, everybody is speaking the same language, and then they're doing something that God doesn't really like. They're building this big tower and trying to be better than God, kind of. And so God says, oh, no, no, that's not happening. You all are going to speak different languages now because you're doing things I don't want you to do. And so he sort of takes away the power of speech for these people, right? And then in the second reading, because people are speaking different languages, they don't understand each other. And then all of a sudden like that, the Holy Spirit comes in and they all can talk to each other just like that. They all understand each other and they're baffled and people think they're drunk and they're crazy. But it was the Holy Spirit that did it to them, right? And they were able to speak. So I think that these readings today are aimed for you seven young people and everybody here gathered today, that this is about finding your voice and having it heard. So part of confirmation is that you become sort of full members of the church. So now when you come to those lovely annual meetings where you talk about the, you know, what's going to happen in the church, I know everybody loves those, right? Yeah, we sit around for an hour or two or three, depending, and we talk about, oh, should we paint this or should we fix that window? They're so exciting. And you guys get to vote at them now, because you are being confirmed today. So you can find your voice. You can stand up at that meeting and say, I think the church service needs to be brightened up a little bit. I want to pick the hymns, right? You picked the hymns today, right? Except for the last one. I picked the last one for you. I'm trying to make them dance down the aisle. We'll see if it works. I told them the Holy Spirit might enter into them, and that they might want to dance. We'll see. But your voice is part of this church, right? You are now confirmed, you get to vote, and your voice is important in this church. Really, every voice is important, but right now, today, your voice is important because you have a different idea about the church than me. Like, if you might think that I want to use my phone in church, so, like, I'm going to look at the Bible through my phone rather than up on the screen or in my actual Bible. Then you can share that voice, right? You can tell that to the people. You might say, I want a band to come in that has a sac, you know, whatever you want. But whatever you are thinking, you are part of the church now, a full part of the church after your ceremony today, and you will have a voice. Now, each one of you is quite unique, right? In this class, Grace, you got to be first today. I think that's a good spot for you. I think you're a real natural leader. I think you know your stuff. We did a lot of confirmation on Zoom, so I got to know you guys over Zoom, and Grace was always ready to answer questions. And we had a scavenger hunt online, and she was fast. She could find things. She has a deep spirituality about her that she can theologize the normal things in life and really put God right central. And so that's pretty impressive. So keep doing that, okay? Jay, or as I like to call you, Ray. No, just kidding. I had messed up the bulletin yesterday, and I called him Ray in the bulletin, so I changed it all. You two have a deep spirituality, and I think you're a bit of a leader in this group, too. The girls all said, I can't believe Jay's not here. He's always first. He's always here first. And I'm going to out you. Jay's hymn was, Were you there when they crucified my Lord? That is spiritual depth, right? That is, to call that hymn out, and that we sing that hymn today, that is really cool. And so you have quite a deep spirituality too, and a commitment to the church, I think. And so keep doing that. I can see you doing lots of great things in this church. Addison, you seem so quiet and meek, but you... You have so much inside you, right? I can see that depth in you as well. And not to mention, you're one of the nicest people, too. You're so nice, I can't stand it. And so keep being that nice. That quiet spirituality is so important. Although, Kim, you said, be still and know that I am God, is your favorite verse yesterday. That's you. That's you, Addison. Be still and know that God is there with you. And that's an important part of the church too, right? That quiet spirituality. So keep being that. And then right beside you is the opposite. The first to talk, always. And that's awesome. Be bold and brave in your faith and in your spirituality, right? We need that too. It's perfect that you two are together because we need both. I'm more like you. I talk first all the time, and I'm noisy and loud and have an opinion about everything. So I'm more like you, but we need both in the church. Pastor Rick is more like you, by the way. And so that's how our marriage works, because I talk and he listens, so that's good. But be bold in your... I just outed us, didn't I? Be bold in your faith, Abby, just as you are in the rest of your life. You sort of have a bit of both. You're a pretty cool kid, and we need cool in this church, right? We need to be more hip sometimes, and you can bring that to this church, I think. And so keep doing what you're doing as well. Be bold and brave too. Sarah said she wanted to walk down the aisle with you because if anybody in this group is dancing, you're dancing. So keep on dancing, girl, okay? Now we'll see if she's actually going to dance since I outed her. Sarah. Pretty Sarah. You have a unique spot here, too, because you're here all the time. And in fact, one day I had to leave from confirmation class, and I said, are you okay in the church? She's like, I'm in the church by myself all the time. You know this church better than any of your classmates. You know the best hiding spots for hide and seek because you spend a lot of time here. So don't let that stop when you leave here because your voice is important too. So keep being who you are and be who you are in this church. Okay? Nathan, you, even more than Grace, always had an answer in class. Your spirituality is deep too. Your knowledge of the Bible might be better than mine. and you are going to do great things in this church and in the world. All of you are going to be amazing. Some of you might be pastors. You have that. This class has got such a great deep faith and spirituality. And what a blessing it is to be a pastor. So if you're going to be that, then be that, right? But whatever you do and wherever you go, keep your faith with you. Let your faith guide you, right? Jesus, in our gospel reading today, said, people were asking, we want to meet this Father that you keep talking about, right? Meaning God. And Jesus says, I'm the Father, right? Listen to me and take me with you wherever you go. And if you can't take me, be better than me. Jesus says that to us today. Be better than me in the acts that you do in the world. Can you imagine that, being better than Jesus? I can see that in you guys, that the things you do in this world can make a difference, right? We talked about the environment. How can you make a difference in the world and the environment? How can you make a difference if your friend is getting bullied in school, or if something is not right, an injustice is being performed and you see it? You can change the world with your actions. All of you can. All of you can take your faith with you today and make the world a better place. You can be better than Jesus. Your actions can be shared throughout the world to make it a more perfect place. Amen. Thanks be to God for that, eh? Well, you guys are probably really ready to get confirmed, aren't you? Yeah, they're pretty excited. So let's sing our hymn, Amazing Grace. This one Sarah picked, and we will sing Amazing Grace, and then we'll get to your confirmation. I should always give myself some notes when I preach because I forget things a lot. And I forgot that I had balloons for you guys. Why would I have balloons for you? There's two reasons. Anna, what's the first reason? Why would I have a balloon for you? What do we do with balloons? We had water balloon fights at our last confirmation class. And why did we do that? Not just because it was a hot day, but why do we do that? To remember our baptism. So I'll leave those water balloons there, and you can all take one. Well, they're not water balloons, but you can make them what you want. And Abby, what is the second reason why we give you balloons? We talked about it yesterday. We did. Wow. Where did you used to get balloons from in this church? Where did you used to get balloons from in this church? Pastor Rick's office. You would stop by his office and get a balloon from him. So that balloon is both from him and I to remind you of your baptism, of your life in church, and to continue on with that, with those two things, right? And the other thing I forgot is that church does not end today with your confirmation, right? It is just a new beginning. So don't say to your parents, I'm confirmed, I don't need to go to church. That is wrong. Right, parents? So I'm inviting you to a church event. It should be pretty exciting. It's next Friday night. It's in Stratford, and it's going to be an epic scavenger hunt. So I'll be going to put these here, too. And you can take, each one of you can take those with you. So remember, the church doesn't end here. It's just the beginning. Right? Now, are you ready to be confirmed? Let's get started. Dear friends, we give thanks to God for the gift of baptism and for the youth of this confirmation program, one with us in the body of Christ, who after successful completion of a one-year confirmation program, will affirm their baptism this day as a sign of their participation in the life of the community of faith and its mission in the world.
Before God and on behalf of this congregation, I present Grace Louise Arts, J. Robert Alexander, Addison Lynn Cook, Abigail Lily McIntosh, Anna Sophia Jeanette McIntosh, Sarah Elizabeth Wetlaufer, Nathan Christopher George Wilker, who desire to make public affirmation of their baptism.
Awesome. Thank you, Cheryl. Let us pray. Merciful God, we thank you for these sisters and brothers whom you have made your own by water and the word in baptism. You have called them to yourself. Grace Louise, J. Robert, Addison Lynn, Abigail Lily, Anna Sophia Jeanette, Sarah Elizabeth, and Nathan Christopher George. You have enlightened them with the gifts of your Spirit and nourished them in the community of faith. Uphold your servants in the gifts and promises of baptism and unite the hearts of all whom you have brought to new birth. We ask this in the name of Christ. Amen. I ask the congregation to stand as we together profess our faith. First, I have a question for you confirmation students. I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, to reject sin and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all forces that defy God? The powers of this world that rebel against God, and the ways of sin that draw you from God. If so, please respond, I renounce them. Excellent. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Congregation may be seated again. Guys, can you turn around? Sisters and brothers who are affirming your faith of baptism today, you have made public profession of your faith just now. Do you intend to continue in the covenant that God made with you in your holy baptism? to live among God's faithful people, to hear the word of God and to share in the Lord's Supper, to proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, to serve all people, following the example of Jesus, to strive for justice and peace for all the earth. If so, please respond, I do, and I ask God to help and guide me. Excellent. People of God, do you promise to support these brothers and sisters of Christ and pray for them in their life in Christ? If so, please respond, we do, and we ask God to help and guide us.
We do, and we ask God to help and guide us.
Let us pray again. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Word and the Holy Spirit, that you have given us new birth. Cleanse us from sin and raise us to eternal life. Amen. Okay, everyone but Grace can once again put you in the right table. So what's going to happen now is each individual student is going to have a bit of time up here. First, I'm going to ask them to read their Bible verse and ask them why they chose it. And then I'm going to invite the families, whoever you want, feel like as family, godparents, anybody else can come forward to lay hands on during the blessing and the confirmation. So we begin. Go ahead, Chris.
Above all, maintain constant love for one another, for love covers a multitude of sins.
Excellent. And tell us why you chose that verse.
I chose this verse because it describes the meaning of love, and you can't forgive. It describes forgiveness and how you can't forgive somebody unless you truly love them.
Excellent. That's wonderful. And forgiveness is such a part of life, isn't it? And That's great. Thank you. Parents, if you want to come forward, and family, whoever wants to come. Anywhere is fine. Yeah. Your sister doesn't want to bless you, Grace. That's okay. Excellent. Stir up, gracious God and Grace Louise, the gift of your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the awe of the Lord, the Spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen.
I turned it off so it wouldn't snap when I plugged it in. There.
Thank you. Okay, Jay, ready for your verse.
For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Excellent. And tell us why you chose that passage.
I chose this verse because it represents how strong the love of God is and that it does not matter who you are, God will always love you.
Perfect. See, you're a preacher, too. Wonderful. If Jay's family wants to come forward. You're getting blessing from two pastors today, too. Wow. That means your confirmation's really going to stick. Okay, let us bless this young man. Stir up in J. Robert the gift of your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the awe of the Lord. The spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. Come on up, Addison. Addison, if you can share your passage with us.
And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and I will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also.
Excellent. And can you tell us why you chose this passage?
Because it's telling you that you always be safe, and wherever you are, God will also be with you.
Excellent. That's a good lesson for us, too. See that quiet, strong voice that you are. Oh, I just lost your page. If Addison's family would like to come forward, and or whomever's with him. Yeah, come on up. The more people, the more blessing you get. That's all there is to it. If you can't get right in, then you can, you can all get in. That's good. Stir up in Addison Lynn the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the awe of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. Amen. Come on up, Abby. Abby, are you ready to read yours?
Be strong and of good courage. Be not frightened, neither be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go.
Excellent. And tell me why you picked that passage.
It tells you that even if you're forgotten, God will always be with you.
Excellent. I sense a theme here today. God is always with you. That's a good theme to have. You kneel, and your family comes forward and lays some hands on you. Poor Pastor Hans has to get up and down every time, 7 times. He should, you could just... Yeah. Ready for your blessing here. Stir up in Abigail Lily the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the awe of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. Amen. Oh, Abby, never forget your Bible. Okay, come on up, Abby. Anna, are you ready to do your passage?
Yeah. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and of good courage. Do not be afraid, nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go.
Excellent. And tell us why you picked that passage.
Because with the knowledge that the Lord is with you wherever you go, it gives you strength and courage.
Excellent. And you need that along the way. Wonderful. And why don't you kneel and your family can come forward, and we have this repeat family. They really know what they're doing because they've been doing one blessing already. So. Stir up in Anna, Sophia, Jeanette, the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the awe of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. Thank you. Good job. Sarah. Sarah, here comes your passage.
For God so loved the world, he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
Excellent. And do you want to tell us why you chose that passage today?
Yes, because that verse is the core of the Bible.
Excellent, yeah. That's why they put it up at football states games, right? John 3:16. Yeah, good. Excellent. Okay, you're going to kneel and your family's going to come forward. And the thing about the family coming forward is you're the people that have supported these young people in their faith all the way through. And so it's very appropriate that godparents and grandparents and whoever is in family comes forward and helps them with the blessings. So. Yeah, good. Stir up in Sarah Elizabeth the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the awe of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. Amen, Sarah. A lot of people with you. That's good. And last but not least, Nathan.
You who live in the shelter of the Most High, who abide in the shadow of the Almighty, will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust.
Excellent. Can you tell us why you picked that passage?
Because no matter what your situation is, you can always find safety and refuge in the name of the Lord.
Excellent. Now, I thought you picked it because it had my last name in it. No? Okay. You can kneel down and your family can come forward. Oh, you got a nice big family coming up to support you, too. Yeah. Okay. If you can't get in, just put your hand on someone else, and that's part of the blessing. Yeah, you can get one. There you go. Stir up in Nathan Christopher George the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the awe of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. Whole family behind you, that's good. Okay. Leave your Bible. Well, do you feel any different? Your hair all still looks good to you. Let us rejoice in these sisters and brothers in Christ. We rejoice with you in the life of baptism. Together we will give thanks and praise to God and proclaim the good news to all the world. You can turn around for these responses. You know the challenge so well. Go out and encourage people everywhere to be disciples of Jesus Christ. We have heard the challenge, but help us, O God, to understand the nature of discipleship. A disciple is ready to learn about the life and teachings, the death and rising of Jesus the Christ. We are ready to learn and to apply the teachings of Jesus.
We know
and gives us eternal hope in his rising to new life. A disciple is always a member of a faith community. She or he works with others for good.
We will strive for active participation in the life of the church. Here we find our friends and are supported by others. From here we can go out to change our neighborhood and our world.
A disciple stands in awe of the love Jesus shared with his friends, the poor of the world, and those most despised.
We want to make a powerful love our own and to welcome many more into the community of the baptized.
So, kids, you can turn around, and I think we should welcome into this community with a round of applause these newly confirmed members of the church. And to prove that you are newly confirmed members of the church, the chair of council, Shirley, is going to give you your certificates. Excellent. Thank you, Shirley. And now that they are full members of the church, we're going to make them work. They're going to do the prayers. So. Please stand as you are able for the prayers of the people.
Trusting God's promise of new life, we pray for the renewal of the church, the world, and of all creation.
Come, Holy Spirit, enliven the church, speak your words of forgiveness and salvation in every language and tongue. Pour out your Spirit on us confirmands in this congregation, that we may continue to live out our faith here in this church, and in this community, and in the world. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Come, Holy Spirit, send cooling breezes where people and creatures are suffering oppressive heat. Save the land from drought and wildfires. Bless the work of those who make it possible to harness the power of the sun and the wind. Help us care for your earth and all her creatures. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Come, Holy Spirit, dispel human arrogance and establish leaders who are humble of heart. Especially, we pray for humility for Russia and strengthen resilience for the Ukraine. Speak peace into all the world. Overcome prejudice and fear. Move us to support international aid organizations and those who provide aid to immigrants and refugees. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Come, Holy Spirit, you hear us when we cry to you. Bring clarity and hope to those living with anxiety, depression, dementia, or addiction. Accompany those who feel weak and worn. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Come, Holy Spirit, to reveal your love to families of all shapes and sizes. Help us to care for our church family, our families at home, and our extended families. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Come, Holy Spirit, you make us children of God and join heirs with Christ. We praise you for all the people whom we love who have passed away. They are your saints and have helped us grow into the good people we are today. This church is built on their feet. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We commend these and all our prayers to you, O God. Come near to us with your saving help. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Take some time to share a sign of God's peace with your neighbor or someone around you.
Thank you.
risen one, as you broke bread with the disciples on the shore, meet us now in this meal. Nourish us to follow you, using our gifts to feed the hungry, tend the weary, and all for your love's sake. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to God.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It's indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, to our Savior Jesus Christ. Fulfilling the promise of the resurrection, you pour out the fire of your Spirit, uniting in one body people of every nation and tongue. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. risen from the dead, gives everyone a place at the welcome table. Alleluia.
Come to the feast.
Congregation may be seated while we commune the confirmation.
Thank you. days, and I am left alone. Your gaze stops my heart, your voice fills the dark, your love is the spark that lights this life.
We're crucified in
body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. God, you have greeted us in our brokenness and nourished us with the body of Christ, broken for us. Risen to new life with you, send us now to bear your healing love into the wounded world. In the name of our risen Savior and Lord. Amen. Just before I give the blessing, Pastor Bonnie had mentioned earlier that she forgets things an awful lot. So do I. I totally forgot that the glasses were on this side as well. We could have had two lines coming up for communion. My apologies, dear. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and grant you his peace. Amen. Our sending song is from our worship book number 674, Let Us Talents and Tongues Employ. Spirit, you have inspired us this day to be witnesses to God's love and power. Help us to be joyful in our service and strong in our faith for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ. Go in peace. The Spirit sends us forth to serve. Thanks be to God.